Donald Trump. He's right now throwing a fit over a Fulton County special grand jury because Trump spent his holiday, well, what he did is he lashed out at District Attorney Fannie Willis, who is going to be calling some high profile witnesses this week in her investigation of Trump's 2020 phone call to Georgia's Secretary of State, Brad Raffensperger, urging him to find extra votes. Here's Trump's rant on Truth Social from this past weekend. He said the young, ambitious, radical left Democrat prosecutor, unquotes, of course, from Georgia, who's presiding over one of the most crime ridden and corrupt places in the US, Fulton County, has put together a grand jury to investigate an absolutely perfect phone call to the Secretary of State. Many lawyers from both sides were knowingly on the call. I also assumed it was taped. I called to fight a rigged, stolen election, and they go after me instead of the people that rigged and stole it. God bless America. It's so interesting. I love how he says there were lawyers on the call, as though having your lawyers present doesn't mean you might be committing crimes. You know, one of his lawyers in particular, I remember, I believe, ended up in handcuffs, but I'll move forward because it definitely seems that Trump has a few reasons to go full Karen and be all upset in this moment. And one of those reasons would definitely be that Raffensperger, who publicly denied Trump's claim that the Georgia election was stolen from him, well, Raffensperger just handedly beat Trump's backed candidate to the surprise of many. This is what the Huffington Post said. Trump endorsed US Rep Jody Heiss, who got 33% of the vote compared with Raffensperger's 52%. Now Raffensperger's upset win may be linked in part to Democratic crossover votes. His victory was the one that surprised Trump the most, according to the Atlanta Journal-Constitution. And also according to an AP analysis, we know a little bit more about these crossover votes and that they were pretty aggressive out in Georgia. At least some 37,000 Democrats showed up for the Republican primary just so that they could elevate Raffensperger over Trump's candidate for potential Georgia Secretary of State. This is wild. So this crossover voting, also known as strategic voting, is not exclusive to Georgia. This primary season, as voters across the political spectrum work to stop Trump-backed extremists from winning control of state and federal governments. The phenomenon is playing out in multiple primary contests, sometimes organically and sometimes in response to a coordinated effort by Trump's opponents. That's right, people are rallying to fight back against Trump, even if they're not in that particular political party. Also, Trump definitely seemed to be terrified because Raffensperger is set to testify tomorrow before that special grand jury that Fannie Willis is putting together. The Secretary of State is slated to be a lead witness in this investigation. And on the table is whether Trump's attempt to interfere with Georgia's election amounted to racketeering. So what we've seen so far is that Willis's investigation appears to now represent the biggest single legal threat to Trump, given that there have been no clear signs that prosecutors at the US Department of Justice or the New York District Attorney's Office are actively preparing to bring criminal charges against a former president. I think that that would speak why he is focused on Fannie Willis and Fulton County right now. What do you think, Jackson?
Well, whenever Trump is screaming the loudest is when he's worried about something. And you know, from everything that I've seen from him, I think one of the biggest things that he's concerned about is his legacy on paper, the way that history is going to remember him once the lights get turned on in the club and everybody sees what's up. You know what I'm saying? Once it's time for everybody to leave and you see what's up, Trump's worried about what's going to be on paper and how people are going to remember him. Because at the end of the day, Trump fumbled and stumbled his way into the presidency. He didn't really want the job. He just wanted it for the clout. And because it was right place, right time, he happened to get in there. So he's really kind of a historical phenomenon, not a good one. But, you know, I think that this, you know, he was on phone saying, just find me 11,780 votes. So there's definitely a lot of meat here. This isn't a nothing burger and he knows it.
No, exactly. And the thing I like about Fannie Willis is that she's going even beyond that phone call and looking for more, you know, because she really wants to lock in her case and ensure that there is something that she can hold on him. Because, of course, if you're going to go after a former president, it's, you know, hey, that's something I don't think a lot of people have done out in these legal streets. And so you want to make sure your case is airtight. And so I definitely commend her for taking all of these steps that are necessary because he's breaking the law. And we all know that, we saw it, we heard it. And that's something that Trump is probably used to doing very much in the private sector. But when you are gambling with American votes and American lives, and as well as our democracy, there needs to be accountability. And so it would be great to see actual accountability. But then again, this is the United States, and accountability is only had for those of us of a certain melanin count or gender.